How do you make a pair of wireless earphones different? Do you add ANC, offer bright colors? No, you slap a touchscreen on. Today, I'm gonna be taking a look at the Wo0Ask Translator Buds A8, a translation device that brings something a little bit unique to the wireless earphone space. The Wo0Ask Translator Buds A8 are a pair of wireless earbuds that come in around $170 with a standalone speaker case that can translate up to 74 different languages, along with 70 accents when online, and even 16 different languages offline, including Hindi, Italian, English, Japanese, and much, much more. They work as a standalone translator or with the earbuds provided, and they have a touchscreen to interact with Chat GPT. They also have in-ear and speaker output modes, noise cancelling technology, and a 2-watt speaker for clear translation in noisy environments. And whilst we have a good look at the design, let's go through the full feature list. So as I mentioned, they can translate between 144 different languages if you include the accents, and up to 16 different languages offline. They work as a standalone translator or with the earbuds, so you can just use the case on its own if you don't want to get the earbuds out. They have a 2-inch touchscreen display with a resolution of 480 by 640 to interact with your ChatGPT and the various settings, which we'll take a look at later. They also have in-ear and speaker output modes, noise cancelling technology, 2-watt speaker for clear translation in noisy environments. Built-in ChatGPT can also provide travel recommendations and itinerary planning, something else we'll look at later on in the video. Quick translations are available, ideal for students or if you are a keen traveler. It also connects via Bluetooth and has 16 gigabytes of onboard memory. It weighs just 90 grams, which is much less than your average phone, and has a Qualcomm quad-core processor. Lastly, it charges via USB Type-C. The earphones have a 40 milliamp hour battery in each earbud and a 1000 milliamp hour battery in the charging case. An impressive rap sheet as far as wireless earphones go, but how do they fare in the real world? We will do an on-camera test, but I've actually had the luxury of using these for the past couple of weeks now, and I've compiled a quick list of the pros and cons. So the things that I found to be really good, they're actually really accurate, especially when translating between the major languages or more commonly spoken languages. They are easy to use, even for people who are not too tech savvy. They're very portable and lightweight, and they also have quite long battery life. They are relatively affordable as well, coming in at around $170. And I believe if you do order them sooner rather than later, they do have some discounts available. And above all else is the touchscreen, which I think is a really unique idea, and considering the price to quality ratio, I actually think you get a lot for your money. So the cons, I've actually struggled to put together a cons list because I've actually really enjoyed using them, and I think they're very innovative for what they are. But there were a couple of things that I noticed. First thing, they are actually quite bulky, although they are small in general compared to a phone, but they can be quite uncomfortable to wear for long periods of time as well. The translation quality can be a little bit choppy at times if you speak too fast, but to be honest, that's the only issue I've noticed with the translation. If you do slow down a little bit and be a little bit more clear, it will pick it up just fine. Lastly, they do not have a built-in SIM card, so you will need to use your phone's data plan if you want to use the translate online function. But do remember, they do have that offline function as well, which will enable you to translate up to 16 different languages, even if you don't have your phone near you. And just an FYI as well, you can also connect to your Wi-Fi. You don't actually have to be connected to your phone, but maybe some sort of SIM plan would be pretty good for those of you who are traveling. Overall though, like I say, it's been pretty difficult to make a cons list for this product. Maybe some color options, but as I said at the start, I think this thing bringing a touchscreen to a pair of wireless earphones is incredible, and I think that just makes them unique enough on its own. So technical bits aside, let's actually test them in the real world and see how they fare. And first thing I want to do is check out the user interface a little. I noticed that they have a recorder app, which although not its primary purpose, I thought was a really cool thing to add. And I can imagine putting these down on the table in, say, a meeting and recording my notes. It's much less bulky and in your face than a mobile phone, and you don't need to be connected to your phone to make use of this feature. Next cool feature is the music tab. Now, of course, you can connect to these and play music through your phone, like using Spotify, for example, as you would with any other wireless earphones, but they do have one cool feature. They come with up to 16 gigabytes of storage, which will enable you to store your songs on here if you so desire. Now, 16 gigabytes is a little bit on the lower side in this day and age, in my opinion, but it should be enough to cover, say, a holiday or a short trip away. Next up is the video feature. Now, don't get me wrong, it's a really cool feature. feature to add, and maybe some of you will make use of it. But with just 16 gigabytes of storage, and if you are making use of the music storage, for example, I don't think many of you will be using this for videos. And to be honest, the screen is so small, I'm not sure you're gonna be watching any movies on it anyway. It's a nice touch, but to be honest, I might be inclined to label this feature as a bit of a gimmick. But question of the day, let me know in the comment section, would you find this feature useful? Now for the important part, the translating features. You're gonna be greeted with four different tabs: voice translation, translator buds, offline translation, and chat AI. Chat AI is your GPT powered assistant slash translator, but we'll get to that later on in the video. So let's kick things off in order. Let's start off with the voice translation first. I'll set language A as English and language B as German, as that's basically the only other language that I can sort of speak a little bit of. Now, what's really nice is in the options, we have the most commonly spoken languages at the top. And then when we click into German, for example, it offers us some additional options like Austria and Switzerland German. So I'll hold the A button on the right hand side of the device to speak and translate my voice. Hello, what's your name?
Hello.
And then when it's released, it'll talk back to me through the case speakers. And if I try that the other way around, I'll hold the B button down to speak in German. Hallo, wie alt bist du?
Hi, how old are you?
Perfect translation, super quick, and you also get a text dialogue on screen, which is really handy for learning and picking up little bits of the language. The idea of the case is that you'd be having a conversation with someone else who also doesn't speak your language, so the case would be on the table, and at this point the German speaker in this case would hold down the B button, like I say, and ask their question. Perfect instantaneous translation. Let's give it one more go and see how it fares. Mein Lieblingsfach ist Kunst.
My favorite subject is art.
And there you go, that's GCSE German for you. But genuinely really impressed, it is translating 100% correct, and to be honest, I think it's looking pretty good so far. But let's change it to a different language and see how it fares with Spanish. So I'll tap the language tab again, keep main input as English, and the second one will now be Spanish. I switch to the dialogue page and it's ready to go. What would you like to order?
¿Qué te gustaría pedir?
And let's try the other way around. Una cerveza grande, por favor. See, this is what I talked about in the cons list. If I talk a little bit too fast, it doesn't quite understand. But if I do it slowly, it will pick it up. Una cerveza grande, por favor.
One big beer, please.
And there you go, that's the extent of my Spanish. So the next tab is the translator buds. Very simple in terms of the interface. It's very similar to the last one we featured. However, in this case, you'll put the earphones in your ears and it'll translate in real time, so you don't need to hold down a button. So this is going to be better for conversations. Everything is exactly the same with this feature. However, you're not going to be able to hear the results, so we're going to sort of flip past this one, but it's exactly the same as using the case, and the translation is perfect. You can actually tap on the earphone as well to stop and start the translation feature, rather than having to press the buttons on the case. And once you do tap the button, it'll just continuously keep going. You don't need to stop and start and keep holding down the button every time you speak. It's a dynamic, continuous conversation. Next up, offline translation. So I'm going to keep it to German because I've got the best chance of understanding both languages, so I can actually gauge how accurate it is. Again, it's exactly the same as the online feature, just with limited languages, and it does just as good a job. As you can see, you can also see I've reached the limit of my German as well, and I'm running out of things to say. So all that is really cool, but the last feature, and probably actually the best feature, even though it's not its primary purpose, is the chat AI feature, which I thought is just another translation option, but it's actually just AI, which to me just made this product way cooler. So I tried making up a question, I asked it to add the total amount of my new budget, and it did a great job. The main purpose, I guess, of this though, is to aid you in your traveling. So we could ask a question like, what are the top 5 attractions to visit in Oxford? And it came back with 5 great suggestions, and there's also the option to get it to speak through the speakerphone or your earphones down below. Now, to be honest, even though I work in tech, I am skeptical about AI. It worries me. I think it's gonna take a lot of people's jobs and it's gonna cause a lot of issues in the future, but there is no denying that having a personal assistant in your ear that can do things like bring up a recipe, tell you where to visit, add your budget up for you, is actually really handy. And these are all things that can be really handy when you're traveling as well. So overall, my opinion is that the Wo0Ask Translator Buds A8 are a fantastic option for those of you who are going to be traveling. Even if you are just going on a casual holiday, I'm sure there is going to be a use case for these as well. And by adding ChatGPT to this device, I feel like when you're not traveling, you can still definitely make use of it. Moving on, it's definitely worth noting the vast improvements over their previous products that I reviewed a couple of years ago. But actually, surprisingly, it was really popular amongst you guys, and the video did really well. So if you are interested in seeing the older iteration, do click the link in the top right hand corner now. For now though, I've been Alex. This has been Take It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.